Have you ever played with oobleck? It's this fascinating fluid that behaves just like water when you hold it, but if you try to punch it, it's like concrete. It's super easy to make and super fun to play with. But why does oobleck behave the way it does? Well, it has to do with something called viscosity, and viscosity is helpful for reasons beyond making certain fluids like oobleck super fun to play with. Engineers can use fluids with different viscosities in lots of ways. Hi, I'm Annika, a first-year student studying creative technology and design at CU Boulder. Let's jump in and get a solid understanding of what viscosity is. Before we talk about viscosity in fluids, we need to understand what a fluid is. A fluid is any substance that flows to take the shape of a container. If you put, say, a rock into a bowl, the rock will hold its shape. That rock is not a fluid. But if you pour water into the bowl, it'll slosh around and take the shape of the bowl, because water is a fluid. And most liquids and gases are fluids. Another way you can define a fluid is that it's a substance that continuously deforms or flows under an applied shear stress. But what is shear stress? Well, to understand this, start by thinking about putting two blocks on top of one another and pushing them in different directions. They move along with the pushing, right? But what if you did that to a block of jello? The jello will deform and bend along with the force. What it experiences is shear stress, a sort of sliding force within a material that causes it to deform. Since jello is a solid, it will eventually break. But when you apply a shear force to a fluid, it won't break, because a fluid can just continue to deform forever. But not all fluids will deform in the same way. If I apply a shear force to water, it'll move super easily. But applying it to this oobleck causes it to become like a solid. And, like I mentioned at the beginning, that's due to viscosity. Viscosity is a measure of a fluid's resistance to shear stress. The more viscous a fluid is, the harder it is to deform. Water, which deforms very easily, has a low viscosity, whereas something like honey has a higher viscosity. And engineers calculate exactly what a fluid's viscosity is using this equation. Tau, the thing that looks kind of like a T, is the shear stress in a fluid. Nu, the little u with a tail, is the viscosity of the fluid. And du over dy is the shear velocity of the fluid. If you've ever seen the Hooke's law equation, which is used to calculate stress in a solid, you'll notice that it's fairly similar. In both equations, the stress in the material is equal to a material property times the strain or velocity of the material. But in order to actually use the equation, you need to know the shear stress and shear velocity of a fluid. And engineers have two ways of getting these measurements. The first way is one that you could do at home. It only works on Newtonian fluids, though, and we'll talk about what that means in a moment. Basically, you fill up a container with the fluid you want to measure. Then you take a ball with known mass and volume, and you drop it into the container. From that, you can measure how long it takes to travel a certain distance, and then calculate the resistance the ball experiences. You can use those measurements, the force of gravity acting on the ball, and a couple of other helpful equations to determine the fluid's viscosity. The second way is used primarily for non-Newtonian fluids because it's more expensive, and it's called rheometry. You use a fancy machine called a rheometer to either control the velocity of a fluid and measure the force it takes to reach that velocity, or to apply a force and measure the resulting velocity. Then, you can plug those values directly into our viscosity equation to determine the fluid's viscosity. So, with a combination of testing and math, engineers can calculate a fluid's viscosity. But what do I mean by Newtonian and non-Newtonian? Well, these are types of fluids, and there's actually four types. To determine what type of fluid a fluid is, engineers use a shear stress rate of shearing strain diagram, which maps the shearing stress of a liquid on the y-axis and the rate of shearing strain on the x-axis. Based on that diagram, an engineer can then determine what kind of fluid they're looking at based on the y-intercept of the line and the slope of that line, which represents the liquid's viscosity. A fluid whose diagram looks like this is called a Newtonian fluid. Newtonian fluids have constant viscosities, shown by the linear slope of the line. Newtonian fluids are what we generally think of as a fluid, things like water, most honeys, and most gases. Engineers use these fluids in many ways, such as in hydraulics to multiply force and gasoline to make vehicles go. A fluid whose diagram looks like this is called a Bingham plastic. Bingham plastics behave as solids at low stresses, and once past a minimum stress called the yield stress, will flow as a fluid. This happens because the fluid has weak bonds holding it together like a solid at low stresses, which break and cause it to behave as a fluid at high stresses. Toothpaste is a Bingham plastic. When you apply stress to the tube, thus applying stress to the fluid, it causes the toothpaste to flow out onto your toothbrush. But when there's no force applied and it's just sitting on your toothbrush, it behaves like a solid. Engineers use Bingham plastics to create certain paints, and many food items, such as applesauce, bread dough, and ketchup, are also Bingham plastics. A fluid whose diagram looks like this is called a shear thinning fluid. The viscosity of these fluids decreases as velocity increases. Basically, the faster you stir a fluid like this, the easier it becomes to stir. An example of a shear thinning fluid is whipped cream. When you use the pressure can storing whipped cream, it applies a massive force to the fluid, allowing the whipped cream to flow out of the nozzle. But once it's on your piece of pie, it sits there kind of like a solid, but it still holds the deforming behavior of a fluid. Fun fact about shear thinning fluids, engineers don't know why they behave the way they do, but they have found plenty of uses for them. Engineers make paints to be shear thinning fluids, so it'll stick to the wall easily. And knowing that blood is a shear thinning fluid allows bioengineers to understand various medical conditions better. The final fluid's diagram looks like this, and is called a shear thickening fluid. These are the opposite of shear thinning fluids. As their velocity increases, so does their viscosity. The faster you try to stir one of these fluids, the harder it'll be to stir. The oobleck I'm playing with is a shear thickening fluid. When I'm not applying any force and just holding it, it spills from my hand like water. But the more force I apply, the more it acts like a solid. These fluids behave this way because they're made of closely packed particles with just enough fluid to fill the spaces between. At low velocities, the fluid flows easily around the particles, making the whole material act like a fluid. At high velocities, the particles collide and jam together, causing friction and resistance that makes the material act like a solid. Engineers use shear thickening fluids for body armor and in vehicle traction control, keeping people safe in various situations. Fluid viscosity is a part of fluid mechanics, which is the study of how fluids react to forces. All engineers need some basic knowledge of fluid mechanics, as most of the things we create involve fluids, whether it be liquids or gases. Knowing a fluid's viscosity, what type of fluid it is, and what that means for how it reacts to forces, allows engineers to use the right fluids for whatever device they're trying to make, and design devices to operate properly and efficiently in environments with fluids. And now, you too know the basics about viscous fluids. And that means you know what makes fluids like oobleck so fun to play with, and you can be a more efficient engineer. Check out the full lesson on Teach Engineering, then use what you learned about viscous fluids in the associated activity, Measuring Viscosity.